kind of scary to even walk.
Mm-hmm. Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Can we help you?
I need no help, but thank you for offering.
During our work session, you're not allowed to speak. I don't know if anybody's allowed to film or not, but...
It's a public hearing,
but it's our work session.
No, it's not. It's not a public session.
Well, the public can attend.
Public session's upstairs.
But the public can attend. We allow people in here.
Whenever.
So, you can stay, but you can't speak. Moving right along.
I didn't wish to speak. I was only responding to him.
That's fine. Venice. I liked Venice okay. But Sunday night, we had gone to an opera, and it had rained some, but that wasn't a problem. We were staying right off St. Mark's Square. And about 10:30, there was 6 inches of water at least covering the square,
yes.
The sidewalks.
They still have the platforms there that they set out so you can walk on?
No.
Because when we were there, they had platforms that they could...
They put platforms out earlier in the year. They say it's very unusual for it to occur this time of year.
Ah.
So they didn't do that. But we went up, we took a day trip up to the Dolomites, beautiful country.
I know I'm not supposed to speak, that's what we did too though.
Oh.
And it was raining.
Well, the meeting hasn't started yet.
We went from Venice to the Dolomites, like in a Mercedes car, he took us up,
and
I got car sick, and it was raining. Would have been a beautiful trip if it wouldn't have been raining. My husband loves Venice though. We stayed right at the Rialto.
Ah, okay. We got lost going back.
Yeah.
Because you couldn't go across the square. It took an hour to find the street. We went to Verona for one day too. That was
where?
Verona. Our son did a summer school thing when he was in Georgia. He took courses somewhere in there. But it was good. By the way, did you get burnt by the lava? You got any burns?
No.
I was on the other
I did.
It's just getting worse, is it not?
The volcano is dying. I wouldn't go near.
I saw another one today in Guatemala, maybe.
Yeah.
And that looked terrific. It didn't kill like 80 people instantly. They couldn't get away from it.
Well, that's because that one just exploded. So the one in Hawaii.
Yeah.
Just kind of
started venting.
You had time to get out, like the California.
Well, I wasn't on that island. I was on a different island.
Can you imagine trying to outdrive the volcano? Those people in Guatemala.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean,
it's your life. That's it. You know.
Yeah, and you don't have a lot of time. They said that the lava in Guatemala was actually moving about 100 yards a minute.
Yeah.
Whoa.
That's fast. A lot of
quick. Yeah, that's way fast.
Wow.
And anyway,
that's scary.
In Hawaii, we actually timed our vacation almost perfectly because the week before we were there, they had big rainstorms on Kauai, which is the island we were going to. And the day we were leaving was the first earthquake on the big island that started all of the eruptions. And the week before we were there, I was saying they had a lot of rain. They had, in one area of the island of Kauai, they had 49.66 inches of rain in 24 hours.
Is it going to stop, though, this lot over there in Hawaii? Is
it just makes makes the state bigger.
Right.
Really?
Give me a hug.
That's all of the islands are anyway.
Yeah, we were there a couple of years ago and saw the lava flowing into the ocean.
Steve, how are you?
How are you?
Rich,
sorry.
Oh, I'll shake hands with you too. Hello. Did you enjoy your trip?
It was wonderful.
I did. It was interesting to say the least.
Because I know you mowed the grass on Saturday, right?
Do we know
Alfred? I believe is going to be here.
So. Without him, you can't vote on the minutes of the May 1st meeting.
I was trying to see when
only you three were there.
Did you guys watch it?
Well, did you read it? Did
you watch it yet?
Did you watch it?
No.
All right.
Because I expected all three of you guys to be here.
but he got.
You have to watch it to be able to butt on it.
We need some support staff, I think.
Yeah, it'd be good.
Susan's posting some kind of sign right now.
They've got 40 seconds. It's plenty of time for them. Oh, he's getting watching. He's putting on time.
3 minutes. I'll be right back.
Actually, I've got a couple of minutes.
He's a little fast.
I'm going to turn my phone off.
Uh-oh.
It's in the car.
It goes with age.
No, well,
he had told me previously he would be here, so.
Okay. I was really counting on y'all to handle everything last month.
We handled everything we could.
Okay. All right.
Well, yeah.
Then I went to China the next day.
I went to work.
Leave the meeting.
13 hours and...
Next meeting, I was probably getting on a plane the next day.
15 hours and 30 minutes on your flight.
I know why people go berserk in those aluminum tubes. I almost went berserk. We flew in back from Venice to Newark, and I was almost fine. But Newark to Atlanta, I was just tired.
Well, we left Shanghai, and it was 13 and a half hours to Dallas.
You guys travel well.
And then we got into Atlanta at midnight, and then we had an hour drive up here. Mm-hmm. I ain't complaining.
My daughter's in Barcelona.
I got to walk on the right wall, so.
Ah, and some beers.
Hi.
Hello.
You come bringing treats?
Is this snacks that we make?
Must be a long meeting.
Get
real food this time.
Susan?
You normally like to stand here. Isn't this where you normally stand?
More often than not, yes, but I might migrate.
Okay. I took your table.
Go ahead and have a seat. I don't think she's going to sit. So.
Okay.
Susan Cummings?
Yes, she was just wiping sinuses.
Oh, I know how that is.
Hi, ladies.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and call the work session to order, and Alfred is the one that's going to get here. Tonight we've got four administrative appeals. We've got a number of variance requests. And as is our custom, I will make the motion to postpone the administrative appeals till the end of the meeting.
If you pass the bylaws in the beginning, you don't have to.
We do have new bylaws.
And the new bylaws put the administrative appeals last.
Yeah, we did make some changes while you were.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
We'll do that.
You could address the appeals here first, or after that?
No.
Regular.
I just have a comment on the order of them.
We can change the order upstate.
I might request it would make sense for the ease of the presentation, whenever you get to them, that number 007 be moved to after 003. So the order would go 03, 07, 04, 05. That would facilitate our presentation.
07, 03, 04, 05.
And I have not had a chance to discuss that with Mr. Bose.
We'll see if there's an objection. But we'll do that actually when we start the public hearings for the administrative fee. Okay, moving right along. VA 180023, tell us about it.
This request involves a buffer variance of 60 feet to allow a buffer to be 0 feet rather than required 60 feet. The applicant is also requesting a side yard variance of 60 feet to allow both side setbacks to be 15 feet rather than the required 75 feet. The a rear yard variance of 50 feet to allow a rear setback to be 25 feet rather than the required 75 feet, and a landscape strip variance of 6 feet along both side property lines and the rear property line. This property is located in District 3.
It's the one on Major Road.
It's where you can read that they own pretty much everything east of west of 400 along Majors Road.
Yeah.
From 400 all the way to 9.
Yeah. And half for many years.
And yes.
And half for years.
Yeah.
My question would be, what happens when they don't own it and we grant all these variances and we're jammed up against the property lines?
That's a good question.
And I don't expect y'all to know the answer. I just, that's...
Well, that's really always a question.
What would happen if they combined the properties into one? Instead of having
parcel.
Four parcels, make it one. However many there are there. Can they do that?
They can. They can through a plat process. They could join the properties. Or they could just make the smaller property larger to...
And it would not be impacted by any zoning requirements or anything, so...
Well, you just make it larger to meet all the zoning
needs. Oh, I understand.
Question is how much are they really...
Hey, Al.
Hey, Al. How much are they going to build into, actually build into 60. Their... into the buffer? I mean, they may be requesting the whole thing, and there still be 10 feet between them and the property line.
Correct. They are M1, so yes, they would have to go through some public hearings. They would have to rezone that A1 parcel.
Okay, they would have to rezone it, too.
Activity.
That's what I was
Sorry.
Right. And I would bet the reason that they don't zone it is taxes. Rezone it now is taxes.
I get it.
We can ask.
I would bet taxes on A1 are less than M1.
But you wouldn't have to rezone the whole thing, you just rezone the piece you need, which is not going to drive the taxes up. But anyway, good questions. Are there others? Moving along then, how about 180025?
The applicant has requested withdrawal of this application.
Oh, that's right. It's not like
that.
Does that require a motion or anything?
Yes.
Okay. You will handle that. I'll handle that. All right. Okay.
Yeah. And we will withdraw without prejudice.
Yes.
It says District 4 in one place and District 5 in another.
I think we determined it was yours.
Yeah. Well, I went by the handwritten form. I think that was kind of where we
were. Yeah, I visited the site.
All right.
Me too.
VA180028.
This request involves a rear yard variance of 10 feet to allow a rear setback to be 15 feet rather than the required 25 feet. This is in District 2.
Oh, this is the deck, yeah. I'm seeing the pool is the deck.
So if I understand it correctly, the existing deck is, even if they did work to the existing deck, they'd still need the variance? Because it's in the setback?
Correct.
It was not, the deck was built non-conforming, correct? Previous as one.
I think it was built before the...
Okay.
The setback?
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Mm-hmm. And it sounds like the footprint's going to be exactly the same.
Yes.
Yeah.
Other questions? VA180029.
This request involves a front yard variance of 27 feet to allow a front setback to be 23 feet rather than the required 50 feet. The applicant is also requesting a side yard variance of 5 feet to allow a side setback to be 20 feet rather than the required 25. This is in District 1.
And that's off County Line Road on Howard Road to build a greenhouse. Doesn't really change the neighborhood, seems to fit in. Don't really have major questions about it. Don't know if y'all do.
Combine there with all the land they've got.
line up back behind the trees.
There's a security issue associated with it. Neighbors.
All right.
Can I forward in an email on this that the applicant has sent in? Mm-hmm.
You don't have a printed copy of that, do you? I read it, but...
would you like a copy?
If you have one, please. And I don't need it right this minute, but we'll make it up for discussion.
Okay.
All right. Do you have two copies?
I can make another. This request involves a rear yard variance of 10 feet to allow a rear setback to be 10 feet rather than the required 20 feet. This is in Commission District 2.
That is the 20.
I have a question. Just the applicant is different than the owner. Is that common?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Is it the pool company?
It's the pool company.
Okay. I just saw an individual's name there.
Questions? If I remember right, the equipment is in the right, really decent place to put it.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I think the pool equipment, yep.
These are snug lots.
Yeah,
that's a nice one.
And I don't have my magnifying glass with me to be able to fully interpret. Yeah.
It's on the side behind the drive.
Yeah.
Pool equipment. There it goes. Yeah. It's right on the side.
Snug lots.
Thank you.
But the.
Curiosity, is that going to be by the neighbor's bedroom? All of the equipment today is so quiet.
Yeah, it is. They can wall it. We can ask if they, you know, if it's an issue, they can put up some sort of screen to drive the sound up as opposed to out.
We'll ask.
You mentioned that it's wooded area, but, you know, behind them, that being.
Yeah,
but
just find it.
Pool
equipment's
going right here.
Who wants to? What's, is that common area?
I think that's common area back there that won't be built on. I don't have concern, I don't have a problem with the pool. It's just the noise coming from here, and if this guy's master bedroom is here, and he runs his pool at night.
It's
awful snug.
It is, and the house next door to that, if you look, a pool?
I don't think it's a pool. I think it's a some type
patio
fire pit, maybe, that did not require a variance.
It looks like there's a chimney there.
Yeah, I'm figuring it'd be blue if it was a pool.
Yeah. Unless it's dead end. Never know.
Then he has other problems because it'll pop out of the ground.
Do you know anything about that parcel?
No. Okay.
All right. Other questions? Let's move on to VA180032.
This request involves a buffer variance of 40 feet to allow a buffer to be 0 feet. The applicant is also requesting a rear yard variance of 40 feet to allow a rear setback to be 10 feet rather than the required 50 feet. And a side yard variance of 40 feet to allow a side setback to be 10 feet rather than the required 50 feet. This is in District 2.
That's over on Bagley Road.
Lots changed in 10 years.
Yep, it has.
My issue is drainage.
reading the emails that we received this afternoon. And what protections will be offered to the adjoining neighborhood to keep water from, because the if I look at the topo right, the neighborhood is about 30 feet below, which means water runs downhill. See, I'm a scientist, right?
Which most means of the time.
He has to offer some type of protection to keep all that water from going in into the neighborhood behind him.
Survey doesn't show any sort of retention that I could delve out with my magnifying glass.
Yeah. That makes sense.
The grading plan.
Parkway overlay, is that applicable here?
Well, all the soil erosion drainage issues would be reviewed when the site development plan was to plan.
Well,
okay, so it's not been there.
So it looks like the neighborhood is about 10 feet below.
Over on this.
Yeah, like 156 down to 146.
You don't have a copy of that email.
Is there another one?
The grading plan is farther in the back. But is this the one that has the staff and engineering?
And is this the grading plan from 2010? Or is this a new grading plan?
The date should be on it. I believe this is the old grading plan.
And the one that's in the book was approved 2010. Yeah.
Do you have a copy of the email? Wasn't there another email on this one today? Mm-hmm. Or is it in here?
Okay, I mean, I still see the grading plan. But again, my issue is when you look at what's depicted is the build out, it's not there.
I printed it, left it on the printer. Well.
My curiosity is are they asking for the variance simply because this is the only place to put it, or are they asking for the variance because this is the most economical way to do it because they don't have to move enough more land? Because there's plenty of land there.
You'd have to take a look back at their application to see if they were specific enough regarding their hardship.
We're in the application. But there's a major drainage issue, mm-hmm. I think. Not a civil engineer. Good questions for upstairs.
Thank you, Sharon.
Thank you.
Let's move along to 1-8-0-0. Oh, wait a minute. Sorry. Are we already?
In C, it mentions the proposed design is necessary in order to facilitate storm water flow. This is the design.
Now, why can't he do that without a bearing?
That sounds like a good question for him.
Other questions?
Shows up for
them. All right, 180033.
This request involves a front yard variance of 35 feet to allow a front setback to be 15 feet rather than 50. This is in District 1.
And
this is an old house.
1984.
That's an old house.
Don't have a major consideration or concern about it. They're just adding to the side of the house, pretty much.
Other questions?
Are they going to add towards the Hunt Bridge Road side or the other side?
No. Depends on how you're magnifying that. I mean,
Go back to this picture here.
It's going away from the Hunt Bridge thing.
Oh, okay.
Yes, it's on the other side of the Hunt.
So, and those are...
It's really in that corner.
Closer to the barns.
Those are barns.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay.
No way to go in the... Well, I'll ask upstairs.
Other questions?
Moving on to 180034.
This request involves a front yard variance of 4 feet to allow a front setback to be 6 feet rather than the required 10 feet. This is in District 2.
That's the corner of the porch.
How did they get this far without realizing this? I'm just curious.
I think it happens more often than we would think that it does. I built my brother-in-law's house 3 feet.
Commercial development, they ought to know that.
The cynical person would say they did it on purpose, they knew it was going to happen. It's the easy way to get it excused.
But should the county?
I'm glad we're not cynical.
Should the county have got it when they looked at the footing?
Yeah. And quite frankly, looking at the, I mean, we're talking
this one just from
less than a foot of the corner.
Fair enough.
Somebody could have just missed the measure.
Other questions, considerations?
I think the question that needs to be asked is, what's the remedy if we don't grant the variance?
I know what the options are. They can go to the county commission, they pay a $250 fee to go before the commission and ask to have our decision reversed. If it is not reversed, then you go to court and try to get it reversed. Those are the two remedies.
Or they can build it where it doesn't look the same.
Yeah. Well,
that's what they said in there.
No, that's not a good remedy. Right.
How much distance has to be between buildings? This is showing 15 feet between this and a future building.
I think for this development, that is the minimum requirement.
And his other remedy is he whacks off 2 feet of the building.
Well, there's three options.
Yeah.
Oh, well, hey, now we get into the APs.
Yes.
A couple of things I want to talk about on the administrative appeals.
Okay.
Barring the rearrangement. Since this is quasi-judicial, I would like to get Rich to run the meetings. The decisions are ours, but Rich will handle the cross, the timing, the so on and so forth, the procedural aspects, if that's okay with you guys. I'm going to make that motion and hopefully somebody will second.
Does it make sense? I'm fundamentally okay with that as long as there's some agreement in advance from the other parties that may be impacted by that.
It's not their
choice. Nobody's going to be impacted. This is our decision.
No, I understand that, but I mean, we're allowing one side to run.
No. Rich represents us.
Okay.
So he's not working. Represented by somebody, and yes, the applicants are represented by somebody. Rich represents us.
would just conduct a hearing and turn it over to y'all to make the decision. Rule on any objections and that sort of thing.
Okay.
I think it makes sense.
Move the process along. Sense.
Pardon me?
Move the process along.
Hopefully.
Good luck.
We still need to, the bylaws have not been adopted.
Right, but, right.
Have you guys?
But that's the first thing on the agenda.
That'll be the first thing upstairs. Or right after.
So that'll handle that. I did have another question. I'm trying to remember. Oh, we will have a break in between
variances
and the appeals. And we may have a break somewhere in the appeals, just depends. Each side gets 45 minutes. Then there's a 10-minute rebuttal.
Unless they request additional time prior to the start of the hearing. And I don't know what they're going to request, but the board has the option of postponing the hearing if it's going to be an inordinate amount of time.
If they do 45 minutes on each appeal for each side.
Yes, I know.
You multiply that out.
I'm not going to get a lot of sleep tonight.
We could hear three of them tonight and two of them and some
only
other
four.
Time. Or two of them tonight and two of them some other time.
Well, there's nothing, they asked for them to be at the same time, but there's nothing binding to us that we have to hear them at the same
time.
That's
true.
Is that correct?
Yeah.
Well, I think the new rule would say that I think you could continue the hearing, you could postpone. It says it is within the board's discretion to grant additional time, that's over the 45 minutes, and or to continue, postpone, or specially set any hearing. So it's on the agenda tonight for 45 minutes, but you're right, there's four of them. So I don't know if they're
45 minutes aside.
Yeah, 45 minutes aside. I don't know.
That's 6 hours by itself without any rebuttal, without any discussion, without any anything.
It may not take that long, though.
We'll see.
I guess what we're discussing is at the end of two of them, if it's 11 o'clock, then we have the option to postpone the remaining two.
Correct.
If at 9 o'clock we were at two of them, we have the option to keep going.
Correct.
So I guess all we're discussing right now is what our options are.
Yeah.
Okay.
How many are next month?
I think I have six variances, no appeals.
Okay, just curious.
I'm a maybe for next month.
Okay. Do we have anything else we need to talk about in the work session?
What date is it next month?
The second, I believe.
Can't be.
No, it's July 10th.
10th or 11th.
I thought the 4th was on a Thursday.
No, wait, July. No,
4th is Wednesday, and the 3rd is what we should have had the meeting. But
it's moved out to the next Tuesday.
Next week.
Okay.
Which is 10th.
Cool.
Thank
you. I think so. All right.
Texas or Georgia?
Texas. And she's in Europe while I'm doing it. So.
She planned it well.
Okay, if we have anything else, this work session is adjourned. Let's move on up.
Just in case. I need some energy for later.
Yeah, you better. I got two or three purple.
Hey, man. Memorial meetings in 8 years. I just want to thank you for what you've done all these years. And so I just want to come back, sit down and meet you. I appreciate it. Great years of service.
Don't promise me.
Oh, wow. Thank you. I just want to tell you.
I appreciate it.
Lots of confidence in this board and you, so. If you point to good people, it always goes good.
These are good bunch.
Yes.
Hey, how are you? Good.
Is there any water here?
I think I'm water.
coming to our meeting?
Yeah, just a little while. Okay. See, that one hadn't been one for 8 years.
Oh.
And so I want to come see him before I get out of here.
Okay.
Got off the Lord tonight. Watch him operate. Watch him operate.
All right. Well, we'll see. Hopefully we won't disappoint.
No. Hey, can't be worse than our meetings. Trust me. Nydia quit coming because they got so bored. Didn't you, Nydia?
Well, it was that in Dawson County.
You what?
Dawson County.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.